है, तो लेट अस सॉल्व फ्यू क्वेश्चंस रिलेटेड टू द डिवीजन रूल, सो दैट फिर आप ये क्वेश्चन को समझ पाओ जो आपका डाउट है ना। तो पहले मैं कुछ क्वेश्चन कराता हूँ बेस्ड ऑन डिवीजन रूल एंड देन आई विल कम टू दिस पार्ट। इज इट क्लियर? And if you don't want to solve it by division rule, even you can solve this question. If you don't want to apply the division rule, even then also you can solve this problem. It depends on you whether you want to apply the division rule or not. If you don't want to apply, then also you can solve. Let me solve this by without applying the division rule. First, I'll solve it by without applying the division rule. Then I'll solve it by applying the division rule. Once I'll solve few questions related to division rule, then I'll show you this question also. तो बिना डिवीजन रूल लगाए इसको कैसे सॉल्व कर सकते हैं? तो देखो, x माइनस वन इनटू x माइनस टू अपॉन रूट x, दिस वाज योर क्वेश्चन है ना। तो कैन आई राइट दिस क्वांटिटी इफ यू मल्टीप्लाई दिस टर्म्स, कैन यू राइट दिस क्वांटिटी एज x स्क्वायर? सी दिस, x इनटू x, x स्क्वायर माइनस ऑफ 2x माइनस ऑफ x प्लस ऑफ 2 डिवाइडेड बाय रूट x, कैन वी डू दैट? टेल मी फर्स्ट प्लीज।
यस सर।
We have just multiplied x minus 1 by x minus 2. I am not applying any division rule. Without using the division rule, I am solving the problem, right? The x square minus of 2x minus of x will become minus of 3x plus of 2 divided by root x. Is it clear? Achha, this can even be written as x square minus of 3x plus of 2 divided by x to the power 1 by 2. Can I say that? Root means power is 1 by 2.
Yes, sir.
Dekho, I am writing few steps just for you to understand. Otherwise, I could have skipped these steps. मैं इसको skip कर गया होता. But मैं सिर्फ तुम्हारे समझने के लिए ये steps लिख रहा हूँ. ये next step भी मैं सिर्फ clear understanding के लिए लिख रहा हूँ. I may have skipped this step, but I am writing this just for you. इसको ऐसे लिख सकते हैं, because this is LCM ना. तो LCM means it is in the denominator of every term. So we can write this as x square by x to the power 1 by 2 minus of 3x upon x to the power 1 by 2 plus of 2 upon x to the power 1 by 2. I can write that. आपको याद होगा कि अगर मैंने ऐसे कर दिया, if we have a to the power m upon b to the power m, so you may have studied this in class 6th or 7th. This can be written as, not a b to the power m, sorry, a to the power m. This can even be written as a to the power m minus of n. Have you studied this law of indices?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
सबने पढ़ा होगा ना ये कि a to the power m upon a to the power n अगर करोगे तो ये कितना हो जाता है? ये हो जाता है a to the power m minus of n. This is the rule. So similarly, can I write this as x 2 minus of 1 by 2? ठीक है. Similarly minus 3 x 1 minus of 1 by 2 and this will be here we don't have any x in the numerator. So this can be written as minus of 1 by 2 only. Did you understand till this step?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
ठीक है, अब इसके आगे का next step I'll solve it on the next page. But let me first simplify this. 2 minus of 1 by 2. So this will become x to the power 3 by 2. Minus of 3x to the power 1 by 2. Plus of 2x to the power minus 1 by 2. We have reached to this step. Now, once we have reached to this step, we can differentiate it. How can we differentiate? So we know that y is equal to x to the power 3 by 2 aaya hai. Plus kya tha aur kya tha? And it was minus 3x to the power 1 by 2. Minus tha. Minus 3x to the power minus 1 by 2, I guess. Ye tha na? 1 by 2. And 2x to the power minus 1 by 2. प्लस 2x टू द पावर माइनस 1 बाई 2. अब इसका dy बाई dx निकालो. अगर आप इसका dy बाई dx निकालोगे तो ये 3 बाई 2 x टू द पावर 3 बाई 2 माइनस ऑफ 1 हो जाएगा. इसी तरह से ये माइनस 3 विल बी एज इट इज. ठीक है, इसका डिफरेंशिएशन करोगे 1 बाई 2 x टू द पावर 1 बाई 2 माइनस ऑफ 1 आएगा. एंड द लास्ट वन इज प्लस ऑफ 2 इन टू, इसका डिफरेंशिएशन विल बी माइनस 1 बाई 2 इन टू x टू द पावर माइनस 1 बाई 2 माइनस ऑफ 1. याद आया भाई? किसको नहीं समझ आया ये स्टेप बताओ. डिफरेंशिएशन यहां पे हो रहा है. दिस स्टेप इज रिलेटेड टू डिफरेंशिएशन. हैव यू अंडरस्टूड दिस स्टेप और नॉट?
यस सर.
यस सर
फिर से बता दो सर
ठीक है इससे पहले का जो स्टेप था वो तो सिंपलीफिकेशन था विच यू हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड इन क्लास 7th और 8th बट दिस इज द पार्ट ऑफ डिफरेंशिएशन व्हाट आई हैव यूज्ड आई एम यूजिंग दिस फॉर्मूला व्हिच सेज x टू द पावर n का अगर डिफरेंशिएशन करोगे इफ यू विल डिफरेंशिएट x टू द पावर n यू विल गेट nx टू द पावर n माइनस 1 एज अ रिजल्ट दैट इज व्हाट आई एम यूजिंग हियर पावर इज 3/2 तो 3/2 * x टू द पावर 3/2 - 1 Here 3 is a constant, it will be kept as it is. You will differentiate only this term. Iska differentiation will be 1/2 x to the power 1/2 minus of 1. Here 2 is constant, it will be as it is. And we will differentiate this part only. Here power is minus 1/2 into x to the power minus 1/2 minus of 1. Okay, this is how you will differentiate. And finally, what will you write? You will write this as 3/2 x to the power. This will become 1/2. Minus of 3/2 x to the power. This is what? This is 1/2 minus of 1. So this will become equal to minus of 1/2. This 2 and this 2 will cancel out. This will become minus of x to the power minus 3/2. Do you agree?
Yes, sir.
You can write this quantity 3/2 as under root x because x to the power 1/2 means root x. Minus of 3/2 and this is x minus 1/2 means it can be written as 1 upon under root x and the last one is x to the power minus 3/2 so you can even write this as 1 upon x to the power 3/2 this is your final answer
yes sir
okay sir
theek hai have you understood now how will you do this
yes sir
theek hai so can we proceed
no sir
happy hard now
What? I didn't get you. फिर से बोलो.
Second का third assignment question.
क्या करना है?
Sir, second assignment का second number question का third.
अच्छा अच्छा. एक और doubt है मतलब.
Yes sir.
ठीक है. फिर से बताना बेटा कौन सा सवाल था? Second का which question?
Third.
Third. Okay. Third में issue आएगा अभी. थर्ड में दो तरीके से कर सकते हो इसको आप ऐसे भी कर सकते हो अगर आपको ऐसे मैं इसको दो तरीके से फिर से कर सकते हैं
बट अभी
ओके ये वाली स्लाइड
यस सर जस्ट अ
सेकंड
गुड आफ्टरनून सर कौन है जिसने गुड आफ्टरनून बोला अभी अश्कार
सो द वन आफ्टर दैट Why you did the differentiation?
Okay, you want me to go to the next slide?
Yes. Sir.
Note it down quick. Then I'll solve the next doubt, and then we'll proceed with some division rule questions. Questions based on the division rule.
So if we do it this way, this won't be wrong then.
Which way, beta?
So instead of using the division rule, if you
yes. Rule is not an important. If you can go otherwise, you can solve otherwise also. So this is a correct method. Of course, it is correct. That is why I am teaching you this method. So you can even do it by in division rule also, or you can do it by simplifying this. ठीक है? It depends on you. Okay. Moving on to the next question, which is the doubt of someone. The question is very simple. Question is simply under root x plus of 1 upon under root x whole square,
so,
right?
After this, please do the division wale se also.
Okay. The fourth question also you want me to discuss?
No, sir. Please solve it in the division method. The second question.
Yeah. Okay. Once I'll teach you some of discuss some of the question based on division rule. Then after I'll solve the same question by division rule. Okay. I've already told you that. But yes, coming to this question, how will you do this? So you know that it is a plus b the whole square format. You can see it. It is a plus b the whole square format. Means you can use the formula of a plus b the whole square to expand this whole equation. You can write this as root x ka square plus of 1 by root x ka square plus of twice of root x into 1 by root x. Formula of a plus b the whole square. A square plus B square plus 2AB. Root x and root x cancels out. So y will become equal to root x square will become only x. This will become 1 plus x, right? plus of 2. Is it correct?
Yes,
means
sir,
even
yes.
you can write this as x plus x to the power minus 1 plus of 2. Now differentiate the whole equation dy by dx. The differentiation of x, that is 1x 1 minus 1 plus of differentiation of x to the power minus 1 minus 1 minus 1. And this is constant without any variable. So the differentiation of this will be 0, right?
Yes.
Okay. So this will become 1x to the power 0 minus of x to the power minus 2. Anything to the power 0 is 1. Okay. So 1 minus of x to the power minus 2, which you can also write it as 1 minus of 1 upon x square. This is your differentiation. Did you understand?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Any other doubt?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Okay, so moving on. I'm giving you some question. We'll discuss some question based on the division rule first. And then we'll move to the integration part. Okay. So I'm taking few questions based on division rule that I explained to you yesterday. First, I'll write the formula that we are going to use for the division rule. What does the division rule have to say? How do we apply the division rule? First, I'll discuss. Again, I'll write that so that you can revise the final formula and final rule. And then I'll start solving some questions. So rule was, if you have any quantity, y is equal to u upon v. If you have two quantities dividing by each other, and the result of that division is y. The result of that division is equal to y. So the rule says that dy by dx will be equal to denominator ka square kar do. You square the I deleted everything, right? You want me to go to the previous slide, but I will not be able to go to the previous slide because I have erased everything. Oh, I may. This is what you want?
Yes, sir.
Okay, hurry up.
Done, sir.
Note, done?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so moving on. So what I was discussing, division rule. Division rule says if you have y is equal to u by v, so you will write dy by dx as, you will square the denominator, and in the numerator, you will write denominator part as it is, and you will differentiate the numerator part. Then you will put a negative sign, and you will keep the numerator part as it is, and then you will differentiate the denominator part. Okay, but remember, while you are differentiating the denominator part, you are not using the v square form. Whatever was the in the denominator, you are differentiating that only. Matlab, bina square wala term ko differentiate kar rahe ho aap. Theek hai? So this is the rule, right? I am taking example first, and then we both will try a few questions. So first, I am solving a question for you. We have a question, say sine x divided by root x. Which rule we can apply here?
Division rule.
Okay, of course, division rule must be applied, right? And what is division rule? The division rule simply says square the denominator. Matlab, what we have in the denominator, we have root x. So square this root x. Once you will square this, now what you will do in the numerator part, you will keep root x as it is and you will differentiate sine x. Now you will put a negative sign. You will keep sine x as it is and you will differentiate root x. Is it clear? Now, use the formula of differentiation. Root x as it is, sine x, differentiation of sine x is cos x minus of sine x. The differentiation of root x, I have solved this. I don't know how many times we have solved this root type of question from yesterday till now. We have solved it many times. So you must be knowing that root means power is 1 by 2. So I can write it as 1 by 2 x to the power 1 by 2 minus of 1. Is it clear? Divided by, then in the denominator, you have root x, the square means you can write it as x square. Okay? Now, can you write, after simplifying, can you write the final result of it? Have you understood this method?
Sir, wahan pe x ho.
Kahan par bete? Oh, sorry, yes. Not x square, rather it is x. Now, is it clear to all?
Yes, sir.
Okay. ठीक है मूविंग ऑन तो आई एम गोइंग टू गिव यू सम क्वेश्चंस व्हिच यू विल ट्राई फर्स्ट एंड देन आई विल डिस्कस ओके हरी अब बेटा ताहिरा एंड तारिक डिड यू अंडरस्टैंड तुम्हें समझ में आ गया
यस सर
ठीक है समझ में आ जाए अगर नहीं समझ में आए बिंदास पूछेंगे अश्कार अफरोज व्हाट अबाउट यू यस पार्डन
नहीं समझ में आया सर कंफ्यूज हो रहा हूं
As usual, you are not getting anything, right? Ashkar, फिर से चुप हो गया. Okay, Ashkar. शायद you will be able to understand with one or two more questions. देखो, I am giving you one more question. Y is equal to. See this. Y is equal to. Say we have x square upon sine x. We have to find out dy by dx. What will be the value of dy by dx? Right? Everybody try it by yourself. Okay? And I am just doing this for Ashkar. This one more question I am solving just for Ashkar Afroz. Rest of the students, please try it by yourself. Ashkar, please switch on your mic. Unmute your mic. Kalia, unmute. Ashkar, I am talking to you. Okay. मुझे ये बताओ Ashkar, ये ऊपर जो लिखा हुआ है x square numerator में और denominator में you have sine x. ये दोनों divide हो रहे हैं या नहीं हो रहे हैं? मतलब is it the case of division or not?
Yeah.
Yeah, of course it is. So if you have the case of division, then these type of quantities, which you have the case of division, is differentiated by using a particular rule, which is called as division rule. And how do we apply this division rule? The division rule simply says that the denominator, jo quantity hai denominator, you will square that denominator. Pehla step clear hai, Afroz ji?
Ji.
फर्स्ट स्टेप इज कि यू विल स्क्वायर द डेनोमिनेटर पहला पॉइंट
ओके
अब ऊपर वाले को न्यूमरेटर कहते हैं ना आप न्यूमरेटर में कैसे क्या करना है तो न्यूमरेटर में आपने करना यह है कि जो डेनोमिनेटर में लिखा हुआ था वो लिख दीजिए और आप पहले किसको डिफरेंशिएट करिए एक्स स्क्वायर को जो न्यूमरेटर में था उसके बाद माइनस साइन लगाइए अब जो न्यूमरेटर में था उसको छोड़ दीजिए ऐसे ही और किसको डिफरेंशिएट करिए साइन एक्स को डिफरेंशिएट करिए जो डेनोमिनेटर में नहीं आई बात समझ पहले ये बताओ यही स्टेप है बाकी कुछ स्टेप नहीं है मुझे ये समझाओ पहले
सॉरी सर
मुझे ये बताओ कि डिड यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस स्टेप
या यस सर
दिस इज हाउ यू हैव टू अप्रोच विद द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ डिवीजन रूल राइट तो बस इतना करना है जो डेनोमिनेटर में उसका स्क्वायर करके लिख देना है ठीक है डेनोमिनेटर में रहेगा बट बस उसको स्क्वायर चढ़ा दो न्यूमरेटर में क्या करना है डिनोमिनेटर वाली क्वांटिटी मल्टीप्लाइड बाय डिफरेंशिएशन ऑफ न्यूमरेटर उसके बाद माइनस साइन न्यूमरेटर वाली क्वांटिटी मल्टीप्लाइड बाय द डिफरेंशिएशन ऑफ डिनोमिनेटर ठीक है तो अब साइन एक्स एज इट इज रह गया एक्स स्क्वायर का डिफरेंशिएशन अश्कर कल मैंने आपको एक फॉर्मूला और सिखाया था कि अगर एक्स टू द पावर एन है तो उसका डिफरेंशिएशन एन एक्स एन माइनस वन होता है इज इट क्लियर जी So if you will differentiate x square, in place of n, we have 2. The value of n is 2. So 2 into x to the power 2 minus 1, this can be written as 2x. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
The differentiation of x square will be 2x minus of x square as it is. Differentiation of sine x is cos x. Differentiation of sine x is cos x divided by sine square x. Is it clear? So you will finally write the answer as 2x sine x minus of x square cos x upon sine square x. Now tell me whether have you understood the rule or not?
Yes, sir. अब अच्छी तरह समझ में आ गया.
Okay, just note it down. I'll take one or two more questions which you will try ताकि आपको और ये clear हो जाए कि आपको सब कुछ समझ आ गया या नहीं. ठीक है? चलिए. बाकी बच्चों, all the students. Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Mona, what you say?
Sir,
can I erase this now, beta?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I'm erasing this. I will be giving you one or two more questions, and then we will start the integration part. So first, let us solve one or two more questions. So the next question that I'm giving you is y is equal to कुछ भी बना लो यार, खुद से कुछ भी कर लो. Y is equal to क्या बना दूं बताओ? 2 sin x divided by x cube. Find dy by dx. बताओ जल्दी. Try it by yourself. I have given you the value of y. You have to differentiate it. So differentiate this y with respect to x, and please let me know the answer. And please गलती नहीं करना. Don't commit any mistakes.
Done, sir.
Very good. Very good.
Done, sir.
Very good. दो बच्चों ने कर लिया. Two of the students have already done. Please, others, increase your speed.
Done, sir.
बहुत बढ़िया. Very good. चलो, now I am doing, and जिससे नहीं हुआ है, please देखो इसको. भाई denominator में कुछ भी लिखा हो, anything, whatever written in the denominator, very good. Anything, whatever written in the denominator, you just have to square that. So square the denominator. What will you write in the numerator portion? Numerator में आप लिखेंगे x cube d upon dx of sin x minus of sin x d upon dx of x cube. This is what you are supposed to do, right? Now, yeah. After this, yes, of course. After this, you just have to use the formula. X cube, as it is, sin x, the differentiation of sin x is cos x. Minus of sin x will be as it is, and the differentiation of x cube. Differentiation of x cube. Can I write it directly 3x square?
Yes, sir.
इसका डिफरेंशिएशन विल बी 3x स्क्वायर अकॉर्डिंग टू द फॉर्मूला दैट वी हैव. अगर किसी को नहीं समझ में आया तो ऐसे किया भाई, 3x 3 टू द पावर 3 माइनस 1 डिवाइडेड बाय दिस विल बिकम x टू द पावर 6. ये बस आंसर है इसका. टाइम पास रूल है. इज इट क्लियर टू ऑल?
यस सर.
यस सर.
ओके, वी मूविंग. ओके, मूविंग ऑन. आई विल बी टेकिंग वन मोर एग्जांपल. ठीक है, आई विल टेक वन मोर एग्जांपल सो दैट आपको एकदम पक्का हो जाइए. उसके बाद वी विल मूव टू द नेक्स्ट पार्ट विच इज इंटीग्रेशन. एनीवेज, तो y इज इक्वल टू व्हाट? कुछ भी ले लेता हूं मैं, मेरी मर्जी. क्या ले लूं? कौन बताएगा? कुछ तुम बताओ क्या लिख दूं. सी, आई एम नॉट राइटिंग दिस क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम एनी बुक. आई एम जस्ट राइटिंग दिस क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम माय माइंड. ठीक है, तो तुम भी हेल्प कर सकते हो. यू कैन हेल्प मी. व्हाट यू वांट टू मी टू राइट? हां बोलो. tan x. वेरी गुड, tan x लिख दिया. और डिनोमिनेटर में क्या ले लें?
x टू द पावर ऑफ
4. चलो, x टू द पावर 4 कर दो. कर दो, तुमने ही क्वेश्चन बताया है मुझे. यू हैव टोल्ड मी दिस क्वेश्चन. ठीक है, यू हैव गिवन मी द आईडिया ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन. जस्ट सॉल्व इट एंड लेट मी नो द आंसर. वेरी गुड, करो कोशिश.
Done, sir.
Very good, sir.
Done, sir.
Good. Anyone else who has completed this?
Done, sir.
Very Done, good, sir. Mona. Done, बहुत sir. बढ़िया, बहुत अच्छी बात. Very good. So I am also solving. Just match your answer, and I think you must have done it correctly. But still, I'll solve it. X to the power 4, the square. Whatever you have denominator, in denominator, just square it. And what will you write in the numerator part? You will write it as x to the power 4 d by dx of tan x then you will put a negative sign, tan x d by dx of x to the power 4. Okay? Now if you differentiate this, you will write differentiation of tan x is sec square x. And tan x as it is, the differentiation of x to the power 4 will be 4x cube divided by x to the power 8. Tell me, is there any issue with any of the student?
No, sir.
Ashkara froze. Ashkara froze. Now is it clear to you?
Okay, yes, good. Yes.
Okay, very good. So till now what we have done is the differentiation part. Okay? Although differentiation also has one more rule, which I'm not discussing now. When it will be required, I'll discuss that rule then only, right? I'm not discussing it now. Whenever it will be required, I'll discuss that rule there only, right? Because I don't want to confuse you with all these rules together. As we are not studying mathematics, we are studying physics. So whenever that rule, if it will be required, I'll discuss that when it will be required. So I'm not going to confuse with another rule. You just have to remember all these rules, whatever we have discussed yet. Bolo.
Back.
Karo?
Back, sir.
बेटा ये कैसे भी नहीं आया, ये tan x का डिफरेंशिएशन है. tan x का कल फॉर्मूला लिखा था मैंने डिफरेंशिएशन का, कि अगर आपका tan x है ना, जैसे sin x का डिफरेंशिएशन cos x होता है, वैसे ही tan x का डिफरेंशिएशन sec square x होता है. तुम चाहो तो मैं इसको प्रूफ कर सकता हूँ, एटलीस्ट मैं इसको तो प्रूफ कर ही सकता हूँ. देखो, जैसे मान लो कि मैं आपसे कह रहा हूँ y is equal to tan x है, तो बेटा यू मस्ट बी नोइंग दिस, कि दिस कैन बी रिटन एज sin x by cos x. If I apply the division rule, तो what I will do, I'll write it as cos square x, denominator का square करते हैं, cos x as it is, you will differentiate sin x, then minus sin, फिर sin x as it is, you will differentiate cos x, ठीक है? तो you can write this as cos x, sin x, the differentiation of sin x is cos x, minus of sin x. The differentiation of cos x is minus sin x upon cos square x. Solve करो तो ये हो जाएगा cos square x plus sin square x upon cos square x. मुझे कौन बताएगा? Who will tell me what is cos square x plus sin square x?
One.
Of course it is one divided by cos square x. तो one upon cos square x is what? Sec square x. One upon cos x is sec x. So that is why I told you the differentiation of tan x is sec square x. Did you understand?
Yes, sir.
ठीक है. Okay, moving on. So I am not taking the next rule into the discussion right now. Whenever it will be required, I'll discuss that rule there only. But now, for now, what we are going to do is we are going to start a concept of integration. We will understand how do we integrate. Although integration, सिर्फ मैं integration की बात करूं, तो integration alone in mathematics syllabus of class 12, integration alone is of 14 marks. जिसके पास maths होगा ना, उसको मैं बता दूं, integration, सिर्फ integration, mathematics में only integration contains 14 marks. 14 marks का integration आता है. You can understand that this integration is a very vast topic. It's a very lengthy topic. It's a very huge topic that you will study in detail in mathematics. Those who don't have mathematics has no worries, should not be worrying about it. Neither the students who has mathematics, but abhi unko integration nahi padhna hai, they will study integration in class 12th. So they should also not worry about it, because jitna hame physics... the portion of integration which we require in physics, that we will discuss here, and we need only that much of integration. Okay, we need differentiation and integration, but of very little bit. Yes, bolo, koi kuch keh raha in between.
Sir, kya aap hame ek bar, mujhe sare hai na tan, cos wagera, actually mujhe bhi inke bare mein idea nahi tha, kya aap ek bar please differentiations ek bar likh ke hame de sakte hain?
Abhi फिर से फॉर्मूला लिख के आपको अभी मैं ड्यूरिंग क्लास तो नहीं दे सकता, बट यस इट विल बी सेंड टू यू, है ना? आपको जैसे असाइनमेंट भेजा जाता है, अश्कार जैसे आपको असाइनमेंट मिलता होगा ना वैसे ही आपको फॉर्मूला आज चला जाएगा आप सबके पास, नॉट ओनली यू, एवरी वन ऑफ यू विल गेट द फॉर्मूलाज ऑफ डिफरेंशिएशन एंड इंटीग्रेशन एज लाइक यू गेट असाइनमेंट यू विल गेट द फॉर्मूला ऑल्सो राइट. तो डोंट वरी अबाउट इट, इट विल बी सेंड टू यू. ठीक है, अभी अगर मैं वो सारे फॉर्मूला लिखूंगा तो वो फिर से टाइम खराब होगा बाकी बच्चों का भी. ठीक है, तो इसलिए वो आपको अलग से मैं भिजवा दूंगा सबको. ठीक है, चलो तो नाउ वी टॉक अबाउट इंटीग्रेशन. अब यहाँ पर डिस्कनेक्ट मत हो जाना भाई प्लीज, और समझना व्हाई डू वी इंटीग्रेट एंड व्हाट इज इंटीग्रेशन. तो लिसन टू मी केयरफुली, व्हाई डू वी इंटीग्रेट. मोहना आर यू हियर, यू लिसनिंग टू एवरीथिंग, यू आर अंडरस्टैंडिंग एवरीथिंग. आई एम यूजिंग हिंदी ऑल्सो, तो आपको हिंदी समझ आ रही है जितना मैं बोल रहा हूँ?
यस सर.
ओके, वेर एवर यू डोंट अंडरस्टैंड हिंदी यू कैन आस्क. Right. Anyways, integration. Why do we integrate? First of all, let us understand why do we integrate. देखो बेटा, if I say, for example, if I say कि let's say we have a rectangle, let's say, and if I ask you to find the area of this rectangle, so you know how to find this area. You will simply tell me what you will just take length and breadth and you will multiply the two and you will give me the area of this, right? For example, if I draw a curve, try to understand what I'm saying. कि अगर I draw this line and I ask you to find the area under this line. So you can calculate the area very easily because you know this structure is of rectangle. This is a rectangle and you know the area of the rectangle and how it is calculated. You know how it will be calculated. So you will just multiply length and breadth and you will tell me that this is the area of this figure, right? If the figure forms a square, you can obviously give me the area of the square also. If this line is like this and this figure is a trapezium, then also you can give me the area of the trapezium because the area of the trapezium is taught to you in class 8th or 9th, half into sum of parallel sides into height. Means if you know the figure which is already taught to you, so you can simply write the area by using the formula how that area is calculated. But on the other hand, beta, if we have a figure which is not known to me, for example, if it is not a general figure that we generally see, for example, let's say if it is a curve, and if I ask you to find the area under this curve, if I ask you, and remember, it is not the part of the circle, I'm saying it is a curve. And if I ask you to find this area, then you don't have any formula to calculate this area. You haven't seen area of this sort. Is it clear? If I say this is a curve, let's say this is a curve. And if I ask you to find the area under this curve, you cannot find this area because you don't know any formula for this calculation of this area. Is it clear to all? Tell me.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, sir.
Of course, you will never be able to find these kind of area, right? By normal means, by normal methods, you know? And when do you get this kind of a structure? Try to understand the difference. If I say I am drawing a graph between y and x, and I think everyone has intuition of graphs. Everyone knows what is a graph, right? So say if I am drawing the graph between y and x, and it comes out to be a straight line. What does this mean? What do you mean by this? If this comes to a straight line, what do you mean by this? So, of course, you mean by this that y is constant. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
X is changing, but the value of y is not changing because y is along y-axis. Okay, so x is changing, but y is not changing because y-axis is not changing. So, you can say this is y is constant. Means out of the two quantity, one is constant. Right? Okay.
Yes,
okay. If on the other hand, if I... get this kind of line. Try to understand, please. Agar nahi samajh mein aaya to poocho. If you get this kind of line, so you can claim here that x is also changing, y is also changing. X is changing, y is also changing. Okay? But because this line is a straight line, I can claim that y and x are linearly related. How are they related? Linear. Means y is proportional to x and the power to both is linear. Is it clear? नहीं आया.
यस सर.
भाई ऐसा आपने ग्राफ ड्रॉ किया 10th में. यू हैव ड्रॉन दिस काइंड ऑफ ग्राफ्स इन 10th इन मैथमेटिक्स.
यस सर.
ठीक है. इफ टू क्वांटिटीज आर वेरिंग विद ईच अदर बट लीनियरली देन यू विल गेट अ स्ट्रेट लाइन. बट ऑन द अदर हैंड इफ आई से y इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू x स्क्वायर मींस y इज चेंजिंग क्वाड्रेटिकली. So you will not get a straight line, you will get a curve. In these cases, you will get a curve. And the area of that curve cannot be calculated by normal methods. Is it clear? If you haven't understand this much of thing, so just try to understand one thing. If you don't know the area under a curve, so you will calculate that area using a mathematical method known as integration. I'm repeating this again. Integration gives you the area under a curve. Listen to me carefully. If I have a curve, the integration will just give me the area of the curve. Did you understand? Why do we integrate? Did you understand that? We integrate to get the area of the curve. Mathematically, agar hum define kare to. Mujhe batao kisko nahi palle pada. Am I audible to everyone or not?
Yes, sir.
Why do we integrate, beta? We integrate to get the area under a curve. Area under a curve. Simple si baat. So how do we get the area under the curve? Try to understand what I'm saying, please. Agar nahi samajh aaya to puchna. Because I'm teaching you why do we integrate and how do we integrate. Then I'll come to the formula part. So try to understand. If I have a curve like this, Ashkar Afroz, if I have a curve like this, and I'm interested in finding the area under the curve, tell me one thing. At every point of the curve, x and y both are varying or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Very good. हर पॉइंट पे एक्स बदल रहा है, y भी बदल रहा है. अरे भाई तारिक क्या हो गया? हर पॉइंट पे x, x और y दोनों बदल रहा है या नहीं? अगर तुम यहाँ पर हो तो x की वैल्यू अलग है, y की वैल्यू अलग है. अगर आप यहाँ पर आ जाओ तो x और y अलग हो जाएगा या नहीं होगा? नहीं आया यार. तो ऐसे केस में बोला क्या गया? What is suggested to us? तो सजेशन इज कि इस कर्व का एक बहुत छोटा सा लेंथ कंसीडर करो. क्या कंसीडर करो? बहुत छोटा सा लेंथ. मेरी बात सुनो मोहना. व्हाट यू आर सपोज टू डू, यू हैव टू टेक अ वेरी स्मॉल लेंथ ऑन दिस कर्व. हाउ स्मॉल? सो स्मॉल दैट दिस लेंथ कैन बी कंसीडर्ड टू बी अप्रोक्सीमेटली जीरो. इट इज नॉट जीरो बट इज सो स्मॉल then it can be considered as zero. What happened, Mona?
Please explain it again.
Okay, I'm explaining this again. Listen to me again. I am saying this to you that if you want to find the area under this particular curve, to do one thing, first take a very small portion of this curve. Take a very small. And how a small portion you are supposed to take here? So that portion should be so small that its length is tending to zero. Means infinite similarly a small length. Did you understand, Mohana? Take a very small value. Achha, why are you taking so small value? Why are you taking such a small value? The reason being, ke dekho, is curve pe, at this curve, y is changing at every point. As you will change x, y will change it. The value of y changes with the change in x, right? But if I go on the curve by a very small distance, if I go from here till here only, and this distance is very small, so approximately, can I claim that y will remain the same from this point to this point? फिर से मेरी बात सुनो बाकी सारे. देखो x के हर value के लिए y की value change हो रही है. But अगर इस curve में मैं बहुत पास जा रहा हूं, यहां से बस यहां तक गया और बहुत पास, बहुत पास, तो मैं ये मान सकता हूं या अज्यूम कर सकता हूं या नहीं कि यहां पर y और यहां पर y अप्रोक्सीमेटली सेम है?
Yes, sir.
नहीं आया भाई, बहुत घटिया रिस्पॉन्स. फिर से सुनो, मैंने ये बोला ना सर कि यहां पर हर पॉइंट पे एट एवरी पॉइंट ऑन द कर्व y इज चेंजिंग विद x. मींस हियर y वैल्यू इज, इफ इट इज y1 तो x इज x1. मान लो यहां पर पहुंचे वेयर x बिकम्स x2, y बिकम्स y2, x3, y becomes y3. मतलब at every point y and x both are changing. But if I take two points very close to each other, मतलब अगर मैं दो पॉइंट बहुत क्लोज ले लूं, for example यहाँ पर x की value मान लो it is 1 meter and at this point x is 1.0000001 meter. तो in going from this point x has changed by a very small value. So y will also change by very small value. So can I consider y to be approximately same इन गोइंग फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट टू दिस पॉइंट?
यस सर.
बस एक ही बच्चे को समझ में आया, बाकी लोग सन्नाटे में. ओहो मौना
सर प्लीज रिपीट दिस.
ओके आई एम रिपीटिंग दिस अगेन. मुझे एक बात बताओ, मैं आपसे ये कह रहा हूं कि इफ आई गो फ्रॉम वन पॉइंट टू अनदर पॉइंट, लेट्स से दिस पॉइंट इज एक्स इज इक्वल टू 4 and at this point x is equal to 10, so I can simply claim that ke x has changed in going from this point to that point. But agar maan lo ke main aapse kahun ki main yahan par tha, I was at x is equal to 4 and now I have came to a new point where x is equal to 4.00000000001, tell me, has the value of x has changed or not? Second case mein value of x has changed, but the change is so small, the change is so small that, yes, that is negligible. So approximately I can consider both the values to be same. Is it clear?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
In the same way, what I'm trying to tell you is that when I was here, this point had a different value of y. When I reaches to this point has a different value of y. But ye jo difference aayega, ye bahut bada aayega ya bahut chota aayega? चेंज ऑफ y इन गोइंग फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट टू दैट पॉइंट और नॉट?
यस
यस.
मान लो दिस पॉइंट इज p, दिस पॉइंट इज q एंड दीज टू पॉइंट आर वेरी क्लोज टू ईच अदर, so I can neglect the change of y in going from p to q or not?
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
ठीक है. Okay. So if I, that is why we are taking dx to be very small, and let me assume that के y is y and this is a strip whose length is dx. So if you look on this strip, so it is a rectangular strip. Can you say that? This strip,
yes, sir,
that you are getting here, okay? Its thickness is dx and its length is y. Is it a rectangle or not? Beto?
Yes, sir.
So, is rectangle ki area agar hum nikale, to can I write this as y dx?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yahan tak sabko samajh mein aaya, mujhe ye batao pehle.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Theek hai. Of course, this is a very small area that I am getting. So I'll write it as dA, because if you have taken this x to be very small, the area will also be very small. So ultimately, I've got this area, but this area is very small. Ab meri baat samjho, logic suno. If I start taking such strips from here, and if I take these strips till here, yahan se main shuru karu, I start taking these strips from here, and I continue taking strips till here, till the whole area is covered. So don't you think if I add all the area of the strips, I'll get the total area under the curve or not? If I take such strips from here till here, and I add the areas of all such strips, don't you think I'll get the area of this curve?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Everyone, please respond to it.
Yes, sir.
अगर मैं ऐसा 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 rectangular strip यहाँ से start करूँ consider करना और करता जाऊं, एक स्ट्रिप दो स्ट्रिप और सबकी एरिया कैलकुलेट करके सबको ऐड कर दूं, तो ये टोटल एरिया अंडर द कर्व पता चल जाएगा या नहीं?
यस सर.
आशकार अफरोज, हैव यू डिसअपीयर्ड अगेन?
नो सर, आई एम हियर ओनली.
ओके, डिड यू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट आई एम सेइंग? यू कैलकुलेटेड द एरिया ऑफ द स्ट्रिप एंड देन यू आर टेकिंग सच स्ट्रिप्स फ्रॉम हियर टिल हियर. इफ यू calculate the area of each strip and add them all, sum up them, so you will get the total area under this curve or not?
Yes, of course. Excuse
of course me, you will sir. Get more now. Yes, excuse.
Sir, they are not perfect rectangles, not all of them.
Of course, they are not. No. They can be considered as perfect rectangles. Why? I'll tell you. Say if it is a circle. Of course, it is a circle. It is a curve, right? But if I take very a small portion of the circle, Ishika, very small part, can I consider this a small part as a straight line or not? Tell me.
Yes, sir.
even on a circle, if you take a very, very, very small portion of the circle, you can consider it as a straight line. That is why I know that it's a curve. And you may be confused, sir, if it is a curve, how can you take it as a straight line? Because I have taken this dx to be very small, beti. And it is very small, so it can even be considered as a straight line. Did you understand, Rishika?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Mauna, did you understand what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Have you understood this, the concept, take the area of one strip and then add the areas of all the strips, you will get the total area under the curve, right? But beta, ek baat samjho. From here till here, there can be any number of strips. यहां से यहां तक बहुत सारे ऐसे ऐसे स्ट्रिप मिलेंगे तो हम कब तक ऐसा करते रहेंगे तो न्यूटन ऑल्सो हैड द सेम इशू तो न्यूटन वॉज वेरी इंटेलिजेंट ही ड्राइव द होल कंप्लीट मैथमेटिकल कॉन्सेप्ट जिसको कैलकुलस कहते हैं जो तुम पढ़ रहे हो ना कल से लेके अभी तक डिफ्रेंसिएशन एंड इंटीग्रेशन इट इज गिवन बाय न्यूटन ओनली ठीक है बिकॉज ही नीडेड इट इन फिजिक्स He derived a new branch of mathematics and that is called as calculus. So Newton told that if this is the idea is very good that you have to take a strip and you have to take such a strips and you will have to add the areas of all such a strips. You will get the total area. But this is not like saying okay, we have only two or three strips like this. We don't have to add only two or three strips. There can be any number of strips. मान लो यहाँ से यहाँ तक I find 100 strips, 100 such strips. So I'll have to solve this 100 individual times and then I'll add them all. Samajh rahe ho meri baat? So Newton told us, you don't do that. Instead, use a mathematical concept I am giving you. And that mathematical concept is called as integration. And what did he say? He said, this is y dx, we will integrate it to get the result of addition of all this quantity. And the snake-like structure that I have drawn here, This is the sign of integration. अगर ये कहीं पे लगा हो तो इसका मतलब है कि ये integrate हो रहा है. कुछ हजम हो रहा है मैंने क्या बोला है अभी तक?
Yes,
why
sir.
Why do we integrate? First tell me why do we integrate? We integrate to get the area under a curve. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
In other words, I am simplifying this further. I will give you further a simple definition of mine. The integration gives you the sum of quantities. Integration is also the process of addition. Integration is also the process of addition. Then, sir, why do we need integration then? If we know how to add, then why are you adding by integration? Integration is used to add variable quantities or large number of quantities, you can say. समझ में आ रही बात इंटीग्रेशन इज ऑल्सो द प्रोसेस ऑफ एडिशन और कॉम्बिनेशन डिड यू अंडरस्टैंड
यस सर
ओके राइट वन सेंटेंस फॉर इंटीग्रेशन लिख लो जो मैं लिखवा रहा हूं राइट वन सेंटेंस फॉर इंटीग्रेशन जस्ट राइट इट इंटीग्रेशन इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ कैलकुलेटिंग एरिया अंडर अ कर्व Integration is a process of calculating area under a curve. Integration is the process of calculating area under a curve. Integration is a process of calculating या finding भी कह सकते हो calculating और फाइंडिंग एरिया अंडर अ कर्व ठीक है एरिया अंडर अ कर्व लिख लिया
यस सर
ओके आगे एक और चीज लिख लो Integration is also the process of addition. Ek aur cheez aage likh lo. Write one more sentence. Integration is also the process of addition. Integration is also the process of addition. Integration is also the process of addition. Everyone kindly tell me, have you written this or not?
Yes, sir.
किसी को कोई इशू है? Anyone having any sort of doubt can ask me.
No.
Before I write the formula, I will now be writing the formula of different cases. But before that, if anyone has any sort of doubt, please ask me. नहीं है?
No, sir.
ठीक है, तो let's move to the formula now. अब देखो बेटा, फॉर्मूला आपको सिर्फ याद कर लेना, यू हैव टू मेमोराइज द फॉर्मूला, व्हाटएवर आई विल राइट ऑन द स्क्रीन यू विल हैव टू रिमेंबर दिस फॉर्मूलास बिकॉज़ इट विल बी यूज्ड इन फिजिक्स, राइट? तो देखो, सबसे पहला फॉर्मूला, द फर्स्ट फॉर्मूला, आश्कर अफरोज, दिस इज जस्ट द फॉर्मूला दैट आई एम राइटिंग, ठीक है? हाउ डू वी अचीव दिस फॉर्मूला, आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू टेल यू बिकॉज इट इज द वास्ट पार्ट ऑफ द मैथमेटिक्स दैट यू विल स्टडी इन क्लास 12, ठीक है? तो यू जस्ट हैव टू रिमेंबर दिस फॉर्मूलास. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इंटीग्रेशन. What does this sign means? ये जो snake-like structure है, this sharp-like structure, snake-like structure. This is the representation for integration. ठीक है? तो integration of dx. अच्छा, dx is very large quantity or it is very small quantity? If I small. Put a d before any quantity, तो it will become a very small quantity. What do you say, Mohuna?
Yes.
If I put d before If I put D before T, so for me, it is very small quantity according to mathematics. And how small? It is so small that its length is negligible, almost tending to zero. So, agar socho, meri baat samjho, meri baat suno. If you take 1 dx, again you take dx, 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 dx. If you add up all these dx, don't you think you will get a net value and that can be written as x? भाई छोटे 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 टुकड़ों को ऐड कर दो, पॉइंट छोटे 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 पॉइंट को ऐड कर दो, तो यू विल गेट द टोटल लेंथ और नॉट?
यस सर.
अंडरस्टैंड दिस वे. फॉर एग्जांपल, लेट्स से दिस डीएक्स इज अ पॉइंट, ठीक है? दिस डीएक्स इज अ पॉइंट, एंड इफ आई गो ऑन एडिंग सच डीएक्स, तो वॉन्ट यू गेट अ लाइन और नॉट? विल यू गेट अ लाइन और नॉट? नहीं है. अरे इस बात को ऐसे समझ लो कि अगर डीएक्स is a point and you go on combining such points, so don't you think you will get a perfectly straight line?
Yes, sir.
Jaane do. If you don't understand, just remember dx, integration of dx is what? Tell me everyone, integration of dx is what?
X.
Achha, aisa agar kisi ke saath bhi likha ho, to uske barabar likh doge. Jaise integration of dt, who will tell me what will be this?
T.
Integration of dt will be t. Very good. Integration of dy, what will be this, the integration of dy?
Y.
No, y. Okay. Similarly, integration of dz. Z. Matlab anything. So now you have understood. Integration of infinitesimally a small quantity will be equal to that quantity. Again, I will repeat it. Integration of infinitesimally a small quantity will be equal to that quantity. ठीक है? Mohammad Ashkar Afroz.
So please repeat it again.
Okay. The integration of infinitesimally a small quantity will be equal to that quantity. See, this is infinitesimally a small quantity, and if I integrate this, I am getting that particular quantity. मतलब इन अदर वर्ड्स यू कैन से कि इफ यू आर इंटीग्रेटिंग डी ऑफ एनीथिंग, तो रिमूव दैट डी एंड राइट दैट क्वांटिटी. देखो, इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ डी एक्स, रिमूव दिस डी एंड राइट एक्स.
यस.
ओके, कैन वी प्रोसीड बेटे? ताहिरा, तारिक.
यस सर.
यस सर.
इशिका.
यस सर.
क्लियर है सबको? पहला फॉर्मूला याद कर लोगे?
Yes, sir.
Okay, moving on to the next formula. X to the power n dx. Okay? Integration of this. The formula is x to the power n plus 1 upon n plus 1. Mm-hmm. I'm just writing the formula. Jaise differentiation mein likha tha, वैसे इसमें भी लिख रहा हूं. यू विल हैव टू जस्ट रिमेंबर दिस. x टू द पावर n dx इज इक्वल टू x टू द पावर n प्लस 1 अपॉन n प्लस 1. I will take some example. Let's say we have x square dx. Integration of this will be x to the power 2 plus 1 upon 2 plus 1. That is x cubed by 3. Let's say we have integration of under root x dx. So we can of course write it as x to the power 1 by 2 dx because root means 1 by 2. So we can write it as x to the power 1 by 2 plus 1 upon 1 by 2 plus 1. Is it clear? So we can write it as x to the power 3 by 2 upon 3 by 2. Is it clear, bete?
Yes.
Please keep responding. Otherwise, I will think that you are not getting anything. So you have to respond if you have understood. Please.
Yes, sir.
Okay, everyone. Okay. Just note it down so that we can proceed.
Done, sir.
Okay.
Done.
Very good. Moving on.
Done.
Okay, very good. Moving on. I'm going to the next formula now. Formula number third. If you have kx to the power n dx, okay? And if I say k is a constant, if k is a constant, ठीक है तो डिफरेंशिएशन में क्या करते थे व्हाट डू यू यूज्ड टू डू विद द कांस्टेंट व्हेन इट वाज मल्टीप्लाइड विद द वेरिएबल जब वो कांस्टेंट वेरिएबल से मल्टीप्लाई नहीं 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 व्हेन कांस्टेंट इज मल्टीप्लाइड विद वेरिएबल
वी यूज्ड टू कीप इट आउटसाइड द ब्रैकेट
ऑफ कोर्स वी यूज्ड टू कीप इट एज इट इज और आउटसाइड व्हाटएवर एंड वी विल जस्ट इंटीग्रेट द वेरिएबल पार्ट इज इट क्लियर द सेम विल बी डन इन द इंटीग्रेशन आल्सो In differentiation as well as in integration, if you have a constant with the variable, so keep the constant as it is and differentiate or integrate the variable part only. Okay, means you will write it as kx to the power n plus 1 upon n plus 1. Correct? For example, I'm taking one or two example. For example, let's say I have 2x square dx. So what would I do? I'll keep 2 as it is, x square dx. Even you can skip this step. You don't need to write it this step. Once you have understood, you can even skip this step. So as 2 is a constant, I'll keep it as it is. And I only integrate x square dx, which will be integrated as x to the power 2 plus 1 upon 2 plus 1. This means that this result will become 2 by 3 x to the power 3. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
देखो अगर इसमें आप ना जबरदस्ती ये दिमाग नहीं चलाओ कि कैसे आया क्या आया तो फिर बड़ी आसान सी बात है कि बस आपको ये सिर्फ याद रखना है ठीक है और आप अभी दिमाग चलाना भी मत कि हाउ वी ड्राइव दीज रिजल्ट्स हाउ वी आर राइटिंग वेयर फ्रॉम वी आर राइटिंग दीज फॉर्मूलाज तो प्लीज मेरी बात मानो यू डोंट हैव टू थिंक अबाउट इट यू जस्ट हैव टू कीप दीज फॉर्मूलाज इन योर माइंड क्लियर है मौना कैन आई प्रोसीड बेटे
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, see, this is required and this we have understood, right? Now, the next point is, if we have more than one term, if you remember in the differentiation also, I told you, if you have more than one term, what will you do if you have more than one term in the case of differentiation? X cube plus of x square. How you used to differentiate this?
Individually.
Individually, right? So similarly, if you have more than one term in the case of integration, for example, let's say x square plus of x cube dx, if you have more than one term in the case of integration, what will you do? How will you differentiate? So you will integrate it individually. Are you getting what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
If you have more than one term in the case of integration also, then you will do what? You will separate them and you will integrate them individually. That is x to the power n1 dx plus or minus x to the power n2 dx. Okay, this is the rule. And you just have to keep this rule in your mind. No other rule is required for you now. You just have to remember this rule only. That's it, right? Means what? If you have x square plus of x cube dx, so first of all, I would write it as x square dx plus of x cube dx, because dx is multiplied with both. You know? And now I will integrate it by the formula x to the power n plus 1 and so on. So x2 plus 1 upon 2 plus 1 plus here, this will become x to the power 3 plus 1 upon 3 plus 1. Means you can write it as x cube by 3 plus of x to the power 4 by 4. Are you convinced?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Note it down. I'll give you one or two questions based on this. ठीक है, उसके बाद फिर हम आगे बात करेंगे. तो please hurry up, note it down till here. Erase कर दूं? Can I erase this?
Yes, sir.
ठीक है, तो मैं erase कर रहा हूं, sir. कर चुका. चलो एक question बताओ तो करके. 2 x to the power 3 by 2 plus of 1 upon under root x dx. Please integrate this for me. Iska result batao. Acha, ye sign lag gaya. This means that you have to integrate it. Please integrate and let me know the result. Please hurry up. Try everybody. What would be the first step? पहला step क्या होएगा? First step would be to separate the two terms, right? Acha, wherever you have a constant, you will keep the constant as it is and you will just integrate the variable part. Okay? So this is how you have to solve, right?
Then, sir.
Okay. और किसी ने कर लिया? One of the student has done it. Anybody else?
Sir, please.
Okay, I'm waiting, Mohana. Please hurry up. Tahira, Tariq, solve कर रहे हो?
Yes, sir.
ठीक है, करो solve. Okay, solve करके बताओ जल्दी. इशिका?
Yes, sir.
सॉल्व नहीं हुआ?
So almost done.
चलो देखो, टाइम ज्यादा लग रहा है, so I'll solve on behalf of you now. देखो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द फर्स्ट स्टेप वुड बी टू सेपरेट देम 2x टू द पावर 3 बाय 2 dx ओके प्लस ऑफ ओके वेरी गुड प्लस ऑफ 1 अपॉन रूट x कैन बी रिटन एज 1 आई एम डूइंग द टू थिंग्स टुगेदर आई हैव रिटन 1 बाय 2 इन ओके वेरी गुड आई हैव रिटन 1 बाय 2 इन प्लेस ऑफ रूट नाउ आई कैन डू व्हाट नाउ सी 2 इज अ कांस्टेंट सो 2 विल बी केप्ट एज इट इज आई विल जस्ट हैव टू इंटीग्रेट दिस x टू द पावर 3 बाय 2 dx अच्छा इसको क्या कर सकते हैं So this can be written as x to the power minus 2 minus 1 by 2 dx. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now what you are supposed to do? You are supposed to apply the formula. X to the power 3 by 2 plus 1 upon 3 by 2 plus 1 plus of x to the power minus 1 by 2 plus 1 upon minus 1 by 2 plus 1. Okay. You have to apply this formula. So what you will get, and now you can simplify, right? You can simplify it. You will get x to the power 5 by 2 upon 5 by 2 plus of x to the power, this will become 1 by 2 upon 1 by 2. And you can finally write the answer as, to isko agar yahan likh deta hu, I'm writing it here. This will become 4 by 5 x to the power 5 by 2 plus of 2x to the power 1 by 2. Is it clear? Everybody please tell
yes,
me
sir.
Frankly. Okay. I'm giving you one more question. ठीक है सॉल्व इट देन आई विल मूव टू द हां बताओ बताओ तारे कुछ कह रहे हो
आई डोंट अंडरस्टैंड दिस लास्ट
वेयर यू डिडंट अंडरस्टैंड मोना प्लीज टेल मी फिर से समझाऊं फिर से समझा दूं ठीक है देखो
यस
मोना डिड यू अंडरस्टैंड और नॉट मोना
यस आई अंडरस्टूड
गुड ठीक है तारिक लिसन टू मी केयरफुली बाकी दोज हु हैव अंडरस्टैंड दिस फॉर अदर्स आई विल बी राइटिंग अ क्वेश्चन ऑन द स्क्रीन दोज हु हैव अंडरस्टूड दिस क्वेश्चन विल ट्राई द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन एंड दोज हु हैवंट अंडरस्टैंड दिस क्वेश्चन विल अंडरस्टैंड दिस क्वेश्चन राइट तो आई एम फर्स्ट राइटिंग द अनदर क्वेश्चन फॉर दोज हु हैव ऑलरेडी अंडरस्टैंड दिस तो आई एम राइटिंग वन मोर क्वेश्चन लेट दिस बी इक्वल टू 4 अपॉन एक्स टू द पावर 3 बाई 2 plus of 5 under root x plus of 2 dx. Those who have already understand the previous question, please note this question and try solving it. Jin logon ko last wala question samajh aa gaya, wo isko note karke solve karne ki koshish karo. Note kar liya?
Yes.
Okay. अच्छा दोज हु हैवंट अंडरस्टूड दिस क्वेश्चन दे आर नाउ सपोज टू अंडरस्टैंड इट ठीक है तो मैं इसको सॉल्व कर रहा हूं दोबारा सो दैट जिनको ये समझ नहीं आया था वो समझ जाए देखो तारिक फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल अगर बीच में प्लस या माइनस साइन हो इफ यू हैव प्लस और माइनस साइन बिटवीन द टू टर्म्स तो पहला काम आप ये करेंगे कि दोनों को अलग अलग लिख देंगे ठीक है लिख दिया अलग अलग ये अलग कर दिया और इसको अलग कर दिया अच्छा सर ये 1 बाई 2 कहां से लिखा तो हमें मालूम है रूट का मतलब 1 बाई 2 होता है ना अब इसमें देखो बेटे
yes.
इसमें 2 है एंड दिस 2 इज कांस्टेंट तो तारिक भाई मैंने अभी आपको बोला कि इफ यू हैव एनी कांस्टेंट तो कांस्टेंट को आप एज इट इज रहने दो ठीक है यू विल इंटीग्रेट द वेरिएबल पार्ट ओनली अच्छा ये x टू द पावर 1 बाई 2 डिनोमिनेटर में है If I take it yes, to the numerator, it will become x to the power minus 1 by 2 or not?
Yes, sir.
ठीक है, अब integration का formula लगा लो. Formula क्या है integration का तारिक? X to the power n dx का integration होता है, x to the power n plus 1 upon n plus 1. Clear है? तो formula yes, लगाओ, x to the power 3 by 2 plus 1 upon 3 by 2 plus 1. Plus of x to the power minus 1 by 2 plus 1 upon minus 1 by 2 plus 1. Did you understand, Tariq?
Yes.
अब इसको simplify कर लो. अब बाकी integration खत्म हो गया. बाकी simplification है. तो 2, 3 by 2 plus 1, 5 by 2 होगा sir. Upon 5 by 2. Plus of 1 में से 1 by 2 को घटा दो. तो 1 by 2 upon 1 by 2 हो जाएगा. अब further simplify कर लोगे, Tariq?
Yes, sir.
अब समझ आ गया ना clear सबको? ठीक है तो इसको नोट करो दूसरा क्वेश्चन सॉल्व करो
सर व्हाट इज द इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ कांस्टेंट
वेरी गुड सी You have a, you may have written this as 2dx, right? And this 2 is a constant. So I have already told you that constant will not be integrated or differentiated because dx is a variable. So if you will take this 2 out of the integration, what you will be left with? You will be left with dx. Is it correct, beta?
Yes.
2 ko bahar kar do, to dx bachega na? And you know the integration of dx. The dx integration of dx is x. Nahi aaya.
Yes, sir, aa gaya.
Very good. Ishika, done, bete.
Almost, sir.
Okay. Mona, are you trying?
Sir, almost done.
Done, sir.
Okay, very good. Very good. Tyra, have you done this?
Almost done.
Almost done. Theek hai. Hurry up.
Done, sir.
Okay, so I am solving this and just match your answer. First of all, because there is plus sign, so I'll separate all these terms. So 4x to the power 3 by 2 plus of 5x to the power 1 by 2 because root can be written as like this into dx plus of 2 times of dx. Now, see this. Next step. We can write this as 4x to the power minus 3 by 2 dx. Did you understand why? Because 4 is a constant. I'll take it out. And x to the power 3 by 2, I'll take it to the numerator. It will become negative. Plus, here 5 is a constant. I'll take it out. And I'll have x to the power 1 by 2 dx. And here 2 is a constant. I'll take it out and we will have only dx. Correct? Now integrate all of this. X to the power minus of 3 by 2 plus of 1 divided by minus of 3 by 2 plus of 1. Is it clear, bete? Plus of 5 into x to the power 1 by 2 plus of 1. Upon 1 by 2 plus of 1. Very good. Plus of 2 as it is, the integration of dx is x. Have you got this much or not?
Yes.
I'm not simplifying it further. Okay. If you have got this step, means you have done it correctly. Sabka ho gaya, bete?
Yes, sir.
Tariq, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Theek hai, toh main erase kar raha hun isko. I am going to erase it.
Yes.
Okay. अब एक और छोटा सा पॉइंट सीखो. This integration that we were doing till now is called as indefinite integration. कौन सा integration? Indefinite. ठीक है. The other kind of integration is called as definite integration. दूसरा जो type है integration का, that is called as definite integration. ठीक है, मेरी बात समझना. डिफिनेट इंटीग्रेशन का क्या मतलब है? डिफिनेट. बेटा टेल मी वन थिंग, व्हाट डू वी मीन बाय इंटीग्रेशन? तो आई जस्ट टोल्ड यू कि इंटीग्रेशन मींस एडिशन, राइट? है ना? इंटीग्रेशन, द अदर मीनिंग ऑफ इंटीग्रेशन इज एडिशन.
यस सर.
ठीक. इफ आई टेल यू टू एड समथिंग एंड इफ आई डोंट give you the limits from where to where you have to add. For example, if I ask you to build a wall and I don't tell you the height of the wall to be built, samajh rahe ho? Main aapse kahun ki ek diwar banao, diwar khadi karo, diwar banao, but main tumhe uski height nahi batau. And if you are very obedient of me, so you will keep building the wall because master ne to height bataya nahi hai, because master has not given any height for the wall. So you will keep on joining the bricks and making the wall, right? But if I, on the other hand, if I tell you to build a high wall of a height of 10 meter, so of course you will draw the wall. Build a wall which will be of height of 10 meter only. After the 10 meter is completed, you will stop building the wall. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So the first kind of integration, where we don't give the limits from where to where you have to add the quantities, if it is not known, so that kind of integration is called एज इनडेफिनेट, इनडेफिनेट जिसका वो नहीं है, मतलब वो फिक्स नहीं है कि कहां से कहां तक उसको इंटीग्रेट करना है. एंड ऑन द अदर हैंड व्हाट इज डेफिनेट इंटीग्रेशन, द मीनिंग ऑफ डेफिनेट इंटीग्रेशन इज कि वेयर यू नो के फ्रॉम वेयर टू वेयर यू हैव टू एड द क्वांटिटी. ठीक है, फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ आई राइट समथिंग से x dx एंड इफ आई राइट हेयर 2 एंड हेयर 4, तो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज लिमिट्स. इसको कहते हैं लोअर लिमिट, कंफ्यूज नहीं होना, थोड़ा सा एक और बात आ गई है तो. और इसको कहते हैं अपर लिमिट, दिस इज कॉल्ड एज अपर लिमिट. मीन्स यू हैव टू इंटीग्रेट दिस x, मीन्स यू हैव टू एड दिस x. कहां से कहां तक? द लोअर वैल्यू ऑफ x विल बी 2 एंड द अपर वैल्यू ऑफ x विल बी 4. मतलब x की मिनिमम वैल्यू इज 2 एंड द मैक्सिमम वैल्यू इज 4. This kind of integration where you have lower limit as well as upper limit is called as definite integration. फिर से मेरी बात सुनो. This kind of integration where you have the values of variable, that you have to take the value of x from 2 to 4. So such integration is called as definite integration. पहले ये बताओ, did you understand what is definite integration?
Yes, sir.
भाई जहां पर आपको ये बोल दिया जाए कि x को यहां से यहां तक इंटीग्रेट करना है, जहां पर आपको वैल्यूज बता दी जाए, वेर यू हैव द वैल्यूज फॉर द वेरिएबल, तो दैट काइंड ऑफ इंटीग्रेशन इज कॉल्ड एज डेफिनेट इंटीग्रेशन. इशिका, मोहना, सक्षम, तारिक, तायरा, टेल मी वेदर हैव यू अंडरस्टूड द डेफिनेशन ऑफ डेफिनेट इंटीग्रेशन.
यस सर,
ठीक है. तो इंटीग्रेशन करेंगे कैसे, कोई रॉकेट साइंस नहीं है. देखो पहला काम तो यही करना है कि भाई इसको लिख देना है, वही जो फॉर्मूला है हमारा, x टू द पावर 1 प्लस 1 पर 1 1 1 लिमिट है 2 से 4, ये ऐसे लिख दो. इसको इंटीग्रेट करोगे तो ये हो जाएगा x स्क्वायर 2 और ये 2 से 4. अब जब आप इतना कर लो, वंस यू हैव डन टिल हियर, अब करना क्या है, जस्ट लिसन टू दैट ओनली. पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ x एज 4, मतलब रिप्लेस दिस 4 x बाय 4 व्हिच इज द अपर वैल्यू ऑफ दिस x. x की मैक्सिमम वैल्यू क्या है, 4 है ना. तो अब क्या कर लो, जब इतना तक कर लो ना, आफ्टर यू हैव डन स्टेप्स टिल हियर, नाउ रिप्लेस द x बाय 4, तो यू राइट इट एज 4 स्क्वायर बाय 2, पुट अ नेगेटिव साइन, देन अगेन पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ x, द लोअर वैल्यू ऑफ x दैट इज 2, 2 का स्क्वायर डिवाइडेड बाय 2, एंड सॉल्व इट, यू विल गेट द आंसर. मींस इट विल बिकम 16 बाय 2 माइनस ऑफ 4 बाय 2, that is 8 minus of 2 is equal to 6. क्या करना है, मैं फिर से रिपीट कर रहा हूं. पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ x, अपर वैल्यू, देन पुट अ नेगेटिव साइन, एंड देन अगेन पुट द लोअर वैल्यू ऑफ x एंड सॉल्व. नहीं समझ आया सर.
यस सर, आ गया.
किसको नहीं आया वो पूछे भाई.
Please
explain this part again. देखो, after you have done all these things, what you are supposed to do, you just have to put these values. These values are whose values are these? So these are the values of x, right? After you have done till here, now what you have to do, the last step, put the value of x as 4. Put a negative sign and then put the value of x as 2. पहले अपर वैल्यू रखो x में और उसके बाद माइनस साइन लगा के लोअर वैल्यू रखो. Should I repeat this again?
No, sir.
Oh, sir.
First, put the upper value of x, then put a negative sign, and then again put the lower value of x. बोलो महुना.
Understood, sir.
Very good. ठीक है, तो अभी आज इतना ही तक. ठीक है, keep today's topic till here. We will solve one or two more questions based on this tomorrow. But today you go and study about this integration, how we have applied the rules and how we have integrated the quantities. ये सब पढ़ लो. You will get an assignment also today. And then we will discuss few more questions, two or three questions of integration tomorrow. And we'll start the chapter of physics tomorrow, which would be kinematics, that is motion in a straight line. क्लियर है?